what's up, guys? Cast Blast back with some Town Hall 10 3-star strategies. Today we're going all air, 3 different attacks, and we're coming at with Matt here, new addition to the clan, great guy. And when you're looking at Town Hall 10, you need to break each part of the base down, guys, and how you're going to do it. First, the enemy queen. She's directly in the center. Getting a kill squad there is going to be next to impossible, but you do have these little inferno islands. So getting part of the base down is going to be your main goal. And as you'll see, what Matt does is he takes out this part of the base with some good ideas and uses air, loons, and hounds for the rest of it. And the other two attacks are going to be with dragons. But there's a general consensus or a general theme on these ideas. Now, without using a kill squad to get to the queen, you're going to use your heroes with a small squad to get that part of the base down. You'll see excellent move mapping out your defensive fire range. He knew that would start shooting his dragon there, right? So it's going to bring some loons in and take out the Wiz Tower and start cutting his funnel. So that baby dragon, a couple loons, goodbye Wiz Tower, and now comes in the king. The king's just going to tank two of these defenses as baby dragon Wiz just keep on cleaning those buildings. So his enemy king, or his king's coming down to about half health, and it's cleared out. As you can see, funnel is cleared out. So his queen's going to aggro here. He's got 5 wall breakers. That's going to get his queen next level and shoot out that inferno. That's, you know, a minimal amount of troops, no spells used really. And it's going to do the job at which he needs it to do. So there goes the wall. There goes his king's ability. And his king just ripped through that just trash ring to allow his queen to get in there and shoot out that inferno tower. So queen shoots out the multi-set inferno. She's going to take a couple pop shots here at that archer tower, skellies, and now comes the loon portion of the base. So you have to think, all right, my kill squad, or what would be a kill squad now is a clear squad, has cleared out this end. What does that leave me left? So this portion of the base is left, and you have to decide how to get the queen down. He brings the skelly spells, and how to work that end of the base. So that's a very exposed air defense, another exposed air defense, and he's going to slowly bring loons in and then hounds. The hounds popping, you know, just like good old queen pop, and the skellies laid down is going to work over this portion of the base. But you have to be pretty confident in knowing what your clear squad / kill squad is going to take out. So there's a pack of loons. There's a pack of loons. In comes 2 hounds. In comes 3 hounds. And now his haste come in is going to get his pack of loons moving quickly on those air defenses. And now comes that rage directly over the queen, over the middle there. Now what it did is it missed his pack of loons. If it was a little bit over, those loons would have worked out a lot better. But it moved in this pack of loons and it raged over the queen, where he's gonna want to drop his skelly spells. So you see rage, skelly spells dropped, enemy queen gone. Now he throws down 2 haste, throws in his packs of loons there, a rage on his other pack, and all those loons under rage clear out that Wiz Tower, clear out that air defense, and they're gonna make it over there to a Tesla. Now a troll Tesla pops up. I know I wasn't expecting that because he didn't really save any troops for it, but his loons are going to make it down there, take that troll Tesla out, and look at all those pups, a couple minis on the backside, and man, that base got crushed. So mapping out those areas and then pre-leading your loons, you know, like I said, he put down a pack, let them work in. So he gets them almost to that kill point, then brings in the hounds, lays down those haste spells, and just rips through the base. And that slow lay down with the quick ending, that's what you want to do. So the next 2 attacks we're going to look at are done with dragons. And this is a mixed attack. remember Town Hall 10, you can either use a kill squad or what I'm calling now a clear squad. And you're going to want to clear out your way to an inferno. So this has some outside infernos-ish islands, but they're set back a bit. But you can clear out. There's only kind of two defenses clearing your first run at that inferno. So clear out those defenses and you got a straight shot at the inferno. But what this also has is very easy reachable air defenses, right? So he's going to use drags, a couple loons, and a hound in the CC to get to those air defenses and then let drags under rage. And I've said it in a couple videos in the past, but guys, our dragon's back. We're going to watch 2 3-star hits on Town Hall 10s over these next videos done with dragons. And this is just absolutely beautiful by Matt. Again, he's going to send his loons and baby drag using that combo again, which we saw the baby drag tanks at first. And then in comes a couple loons at that archer tower. And as they get to that archer tower, there goes the archer tower, and his baby drag is left with a little bit of health to finish up what it's doing. So now here comes his heroes. His king's a good tanker again, and they're going to clear out this section and clear out that air defense and a couple other buildings and defenses, because you have to funnel dragons in. This is just an old Town Hall 8 skill again, funneling your dragons to where you need them, right? So he's clearing out. There goes an air defense. That baby dragon up top cleared out a nice area. And then his dragons are coming straight in the middle once again to rip through the base. So queen steps up. She does work. And as the buildings and defenses get cleared out, that leaves a straight shot to that air defense, a haste and a handful of loons, right? So that air defenses are your main dragon killer. So that leaves 2 air defenses. Now he's going to let the attack develop and save the hound and a bunch of loons to take out these easily reachable defenses. And planning around those certain areas is what you want to do. So in comes a couple rages. The dragons deal with the queen. They deal with, remember, people in the CCs, they're using hounds and golems now so that you can't use a kill squad. And what do I always say? If you can't use a kill squad because of these high HP troops, just hit it with air, man. All these tactics from Town Hall 9, like Queen Pop and Benchin, is coming back at Town Hall 10 now that everyone's just throwing hounds and loons in there, or hounds and golems in their CC. Just rip through the base with air. So this gets very close. As we'll see right here, his loon pathing, right? So loons kind of path there. He wanted loons to path directly across here, but they get hit with some splash and they kind of get hit susceptibly, falling down way too quick. They focus over in on that cannon and then to the air defense, and they don't take that second air defense down. So fortunately, the hound popped. The pups are under rage there, which is beautiful. Pups just multi-use, man. They under rage. They take out that air defense. These drags finish up the last whiz tower. His queen's still alive with those pups and drags, and they clean out the rest of the base. And just beautiful, beautiful work there. 3-star attack, as you'll see his troops here. Once again, dragons, loons, using that baby drag loon trick to tank and take out, man. I'm loving that. And let's take a look at the last 3-star hit done once again by dragons and how we're going to take a look at Town Hall 10s. So what we're looking at here, not a full upgraded or a high Town Hall 10 like those other ones, but he makes the move of putting all air defenses on one side and all other defenses on the other. And we've seen my clan work this type of base over before with some hogs. And now we're going to see it, and dragons once, and now we're going to see it with dragons again. So that queen's kind of in the middle there, but these defenses are easily reachable with a small kill squad, letting drags just work over the other end of the base. Guys, are drags back? Man, this is beautiful. Town Hall 10 3-stars are always just fun to watch. They take some base reading, base planning, and they're just fun. They're fun. So you'll see the whole thing of this base, you know, he's got to kind of clear it out. What you want to do is just work your normal funnel and get your troops in to clear out all these air defenses. It's a simple idea, simple plan. So he brings in some golems. Of course, there's troll Teslas out there. Why not? And then wizards, and they're going to start clearing out a nice funnel. His bowlers come in with a jump. As that funnel's being cleared, that's going to force all his troops in the middle there. And the CC is being pulled. One rage down, that's going to get his troops ripping through the CC, ripping through all the air defenses, and even probably moving up to blast away the next level, which it does, as you'll see. Those golems are tanking nicely. So instead of loons and hounds like we saw on the last attack, it's seven drags again, but he's able to bring a bigger kill squad to get into the base. Being this base is so heavily separated where his defensive power is sitting. On the last base, you wouldn't have got deep inside a base like that. But his troops work nicely. Now his king's going to sit there and just punch away at a wall for about 5 hours. But once he gets through that wall, his queen's going to go next level, get the air defense and that expo down. As he's doing that, he's already bringing a baby drag to start a funneling process. And it's working nicely. And that has successfully gotten that inferno down and cleared out everything that his drags can go directly in at the next inferno and then over at the rest of the base. You have to funnel dragons. Dragons, you know, they're like the big, slow, mindless tank that just deals out power. If you don't give them the exact pathing that you want them to run, they'll go in every direction. Once again, hopefully we've learned this doing like Town Hall 8, Town Hall 9 dragon, Town Hall 7 drag attacks. You have to tell your dragons what to do. Is Queen's still working her way? You know, he's using haste there. Why not? And his dragons just keep on working. In comes a rage to finish off the last couple defenses. Wizard, he's got two wizards left to kind of just clean up some of the junk around the base. But guys, look, he brought seven dragons with him, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Has he lost a dragon? Man, these things are a lot of fun lately. So the quicker, you know, attack, pre-attack with when the dragons got the buff a little while ago and a couple extra levels at certain town halls, but their first shot is quicker now as of a couple updates ago, and it's just made them fun. As you'll see that seven dragons on both attacks, a different philosophy in kill squad, but getting each job done, whether it's taking out all their defenses together or using the clearing path as you can take it out and then just backdoor with a hound, whatever it is, Town Hall 10 has become a lot more fun recently. So I hope you guys like it. Hope you appreciate it. Press like and subscribe. Big shout out to Matt and Chris here on those 9 Town Hall 10 3 stars or 9 stars at Town Hall 10 over the last 2 wars. I don't think recaps are going to come back. Sorry to throw that out there. We'll probably just do some cool hits off each one. I guess other clans didn't really appreciate recaps for some reason. So we'll keep on looking at some great attacks there. Definitely check us out, AZ Wildcats. Make sure you're following me on Twitter at CastAndBlast_COC. As always, ask me questions if you got them. I appreciate you guys, and I'll see you guys next time.